See, I mean, 2014, we'll be having what we call on midterm elections. There will be 15 seats from the Senate that will be up for election by next year, October. And then 2017, there will be another election for the entire legislature, the entire House of Representatives, and the president and the vice president. There's no plan from the perspective of a woman. And now we are in the constitutional review process. So this is an opportunity to see how we can influence this process so that constitutional guarantees can be put in place to make sure that women will always be have a space in national affairs.
Nepal is very different. Like in South Asia, Nepal, India is very, very different from the examples that was given of the African countries or from the other countries as such, because we also have caste system that is very hierarchical, as well as we have more than 120 ethnic communities. Then we also have in the southern belt of our country, the Madhes community. Now, all these are not a homogeneous group. What we've also seen, the mindset, or when we interact with the politicians, the mindset is that they might not be so flexible this time. They felt that they were very flexible in the 2008 and 2012, during that time, but they might move more towards a radical stand.
Are the women that they are writing the constitution now, they are not activists and they are not the actors of the civil society and in the feminist and feminism movement in Tunisia before. These women that they are elected in this constitution, one of the main issues that they can't until now take off the hats of their party, and they treat the new laws concerning women issue, women rights, minorities from the perspective of their party and not from the hats of the feminism.
It's very important to look at the overall situation that marginalized communities face, especially the structural discrimination that may prevent communities from organizing, from participating fully in the economic and social life of their countries. And when this is the case, then they won't be able to have developed the know-how in order to participate in constitution building processes.
How, by designing a proper constitution making process that includes the minorities and marginalized communities, you can actually end up with a product, both in terms of the specific chapters and provisions in the constitution that reflect the wishes of those people. So it was, first of all, to really underscore the fundamentals of why you're making a constitution, why we in Kenya made a constitution at the time we did. And at the end of the day, were we able, were we satisfied with the results, the outcome of our work? And especially in the context of the subject matter of this conference, which is the inclusion of minorities and marginalized communities.
Despite all the difficulties, we have managed to get into the decision-making body, which is a constituent assembly in 2008. But prior to that, we laid ground by building LGBTI groups into the rural areas, townships and cities in Nepal, across Nepal, raising voices, awareness and visibility. Then taking the government to the court, so ensuring identity for third gender ID, or creating a separate category of gender. So Nepal officially recognized three genders through the Supreme Court of Nepal since 2007, and also ordered the government to amend and change all the discrimination laws against LGBTI. Was a very historic decision from Supreme Court of Nepal.